morning.
Good morning.
Well, I thought I'd make a statement around the Amazon issue. Like everybody else in Baltimore, as I said in my statement that I released, that we're very disappointed that we were not selected among the top 20. I guess I'm probably like 218 other cities probably holding very similar press conference right now, thinking, wow, why weren't we selected? But let me just say this, that if you don't get in the game, you don't get selected. And so we were glad that so many in our business community came together to pull together what we consider to be a magnificent proposal. And while we didn't win this one, maybe it's the next one or the one after that. And so I'm really grateful to all of those in the business community who pulled together to put together what I consider not only a unique proposal, but one of the best proposals. We may never know why we weren't selected, but what we do know is that we have great business people in our community who are always prepared to come together when we ask them to. And you know, one of the things that I continue to say to the business community is that these kinds of opportunities, we should not be sitting on the sidelines waiting for them to happen. So we will continue to look for efforts to bring companies and corporations to Baltimore, because we do consider this a great city with great opportunities. And certainly Port Covington, shovel ready, to us was boom, the best proposal ever. But again, I want to thank all of those in the business community who came together. Bill, thank you for the magnificent job of coordination to make sure that the business community understood how important this was to Baltimore. But what I don't want you all to walk away with thinking is that this is the only thing that we're going after. Every time an opportunity presents itself, Baltimore will be in the mix. We will put our best foot forward. We will go after every opportunity that's out there, because we believe in Baltimore. We believe that the opportunities are here. You all see all the apartment buildings going up in Baltimore, and young people think this is the coolest place in the country to live in. New York Times said we're the 15th city out of 32 cities around the world to visit. And so we're excited about what we will do in the future, but again, we certainly are disappointed with this particular outcome. Would you like to say anything, Don?
You know, on behalf of the Greater Baltimore Committee and Business Committee, we certainly are also very disappointed that the Baltimore did not make the cut. But I just want to commend the mayor and also commend Baltimore Development Corporation and others who worked very hard and put together what I think was a very competitive proposal, one that certainly highlighted the great attributes of Baltimore, talked about our highly trained and educated workforce, talked about a great location, talked about the private sector investment that's taking place. And again, as the mayor said, although we may not have made this cut, I think that hopefully our proposal and our willingness to work together as a group will show other companies and other groups that this is a great place to locate, and we look forward to pursuing any other opportunities that would come our way.
I also want to take a moment to thank the governor as well, because he put a lot into this effort. Baltimore was his choice in terms of a city to be invested in. We certainly are grateful for that. Bill, did you want to share a few words?
Madam Mayor, as you know, this was one of the most collaborative efforts that we've ever been a part of, and Don and others rallied to help us get this proposal in. Disappointment is the right word. We will use the collaboration that we put forth in this effort to pursue every and all opportunities in the future.
Any questions for me? Yes.
Apple is now looking around.
Yay. Apples, peaches, whatever is out there, we're going after them. Well, it's, you know, all of it was, some of it was preparatory, and so we look forward to getting it, and we will share it as it comes to us. But you're absolutely right. Apple is looking, whoever's out there looking for a great city to locate in, we'll be preparing a proposal for them as well.
I'm not trying to be negative or anything, but is this another punch in the stomach for a city that was looking for something to kind of latch onto to get back into a better place, considering what's been happening with all the violence in the city that's taken the front?
Well, I think if you look at the list, there are cities there that are violent. So I don't think that violence was actually the determining factor. You have some other cities on there that have pretty high numbers as well. So I don't think that that's the issue for us. And I don't think that that was actually the determining factor for Amazon. I think disappointment is the better word. not a punch in the stomach. I feel pretty good. I had good breakfast this morning, and I feel good. And so, I think I feel on behalf of all the citizens of Baltimore disappointed.
However you'd be, perhaps some would say naive, to ignore the fact that in the midst of when they were making this decision, the Souter case happened, unsolved, officer shot.
But again, I think if you go over the list and take a look at the list, there are cities on that list who have comparable crime rates.
So you don't think that was a factor in Amazon's decision?
We may never know what the factors were as it relates to the Amazon decision. What I'm saying is that we continue to put our best foot forward, and whatever the next opportunity is, we'll be right there for it. If you don't get in the game, you don't get a chance to be chosen or not chosen.
When you make your proposal to Apple, how will you change things around to make it?
I think we had a great proposal, and so I don't think that there's much that we would change. I think that when you think about Port Covington as a ready-made area for development, and I believe that they're continuing to look for investment and opportunities, there are companies and corporations that are still looking at that particular area. So we're very excited about what will come to that area.
But if that proposal did not work for Amazon, what makes you think it would work for someone else?
Well, just like I'm sure that there are 218 other cities who proposed, who are standing just as I'm standing today. I'm sure that whatever the issues were for them, they too will do the same as I am doing, continuing to push forward because we believe we have great opportunities in this city and we will continue to do that.
Your Honor, with the collaborative effort, is there an actual committee that is aggressively going out and going after companies?
Well, let me just say, this is what I've said to Bill Cole. He is our Baltimore Development Corporation president. That we don't sit back anymore and wait for opportunities to come to us. We are looking every single day for other opportunities, and I know that he's being very aggressive in doing that. And so we are fully aware of the Apple proposal, and we will, continue to be aware of other opportunities that may present themselves, and we look forward to presenting.
I saw three of the 20 that made the list, all are within a stone's throw of the nation.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Did that overshadow Baltimore somewhat? They were really interested in DC and being close to
them. So I think we can make all kind of, it's easy to Monday morning quarterback. It's much easier to continue to move forward.
Is there concerns that the perception of Under Armour and its struggles with tying with Port Covington makes that site less desirable?
Well, let me just say, I think Under Armour and Tom Geddes and the crew was very, very great partners. And I think, again, Port Covington offers wonderful opportunities for any company or corporation to take a look at the opportunities there to grow and expand.
I don't know if this is trying to turn a negative from a positive. Say it is built in Montgomery County. That could mean folks from Baltimore or folks that are going to work there could choose to live in this area for cheaper housing.
Let me just say congratulations to Montgomery County for making the list, and to the extent that we could be helpful, we certainly would be, and to the extent that we can collaborate, we certainly will.
Is there anything that you can tell us that we didn't already know about what was in the package now that we're no longer in the line?
So, when we can release that, we will absolutely do that. Again, some of it is proprietary. And some of it isn't, and as soon as we can release that, we'll be glad to share it with you.
Because there's some talk that Maryland sometimes doesn't throw enough actual dollars.
Well, I can't say that in this case. I do know the governor was very, very encouraging and offered some great incentives for this particular proposal because I think he realized the impact that it could have on the city. But again, this is one. You'll see me in this role go after many, many more. Okay? No, I cannot. I think he'll share that with you. I think he's having a press conference today.
No, but in terms of the incentives that were discussed for Baltimore, so for Port Covington, can you talk at all about what you were hoping the state would put in?
No. Okay, thank you, everybody.
Are you going to still continue to talk to Amazon?
Well, Amazon does have a location here. Right. They are expanding in Baltimore County. We are working. They're a great corporate partner, and we're very excited about working with Amazon. Thank you, everybody.
they're just focused on retention. They're not the guys for